Earth observation satellites orbit between 111 miles and 1,200 miles above the surface. So how the heck can they spot my car in the driveway? Hey y'all, Trace here for your weekly DNews space update. There's this amazing political commitment called the International Charter on Space and Major Disasters. The charter was created after the Unispace 3 conference in 1999 as a framework for sharing of satellite data amongst member states in the case of a disaster. Pretty much all of the satellite operating countries are members. China activated the charter after the Malaysian Airlines Boeing 777 disappeared. Once activated, member agencies determine which satellites can be tasked with shooting pictures of the area of interest. Usually it's a location like of a tsunami or an earthquake. This is the first time the charter has been activated to hunt down a missing airliner. Conspiracy theorists assume spy satellites can just zoom in and read a book over your shoulder, but the Earth, it's real big, y'all. Anyone who's used Google Earth knows this stuff. You can spend days on there. But how does a thing 1,200 miles away make out a tiny airplane, or like I said, car or bike in my driveway? Back in the day, the recently declassified Gambit and Hexagon American spy satellites used large format film dropped from space and developed on the ground. Digital camera technology exists in part because of the space program's want for digital images. Three companies, GOI, Digital Globe, and Spot Image, employ about a dozen satellites just for ground imaging. Governments, agencies, and private companies all have their own camera-equipped satellites, but the specs for some of those are secret. The GOI 1 says that they can capture 700 million pixels per second with a black and white resolution of 16 inches per pixel. The most famous Earth imaging satellites are the Keyhole satellites. They're probably the best, and some version has been orbiting for more than three decades. The KH satellite is basically a giant orbiting lens, kind of like the Hubble telescope, but instead of pointing at faraway galaxies, they are pointing at terrorists and enemies of the state and that little red book you've been reading in the park. How Stuff Works says the Keyhole satellites can use cameras to see things as small as 5 inches per pixel. So they can't tell what book you're reading, but they sure as heck can see that book. When it comes to spotting very specific things though, lenses and digital cameras inside satellites have to point at the right place at the right time. So if you're worried someone is spying on you, you probably shouldn't be worried someone's spying on you. All this doesn't mean jack squat without some serious data analysis. There are whole industries built around the analysis of the images and data from these space satellites. Think about it, 700 megapixels every second is a lot of visual information, and computers aren't really great at picking out visual details. With regard to the missing Malaysian airline, NASA is looking through the archives of their satellite data to see if any equipment was over the area at the relevant time. China's satellites spotted some debris on Sunday, but it's just small pieces of debris, and it's in a constantly moving ocean, so they're kind of difficult to identify. So far, no one has found anything of substance. The internet has been a game changer for this type of human-centric analysis. Digital Globe has made its entire library of relevant photos available to help search for the missing airplane. And over 100,000 people so far have signed up to help out. That's better than a supercomputer any day. Are spy satellites nothing to worry about, or am I just underestimating the power of these spy agencies? Tell me your opinion below, and thanks a lot for watching. Subscribe for more DNews.